That way we'll have our own Sonic. Basically, at some point, I know there's a Sonic Twitter takeover. At some point, there should be a Sonic Twitch takeover.
Yes.
Yeah.
That
so,
I better get KM.
If you guys want to meet us in the Sonic R Show studio audience room, we will be taking your questions up there. If you want to come up on stage and ask your questions, we'll be more than happy to answer them. And if you don't feel like talking on air, we'll try to take your questions in the Sonic R Show discussion room on Discord or in the Twitch chat room. So, we'll jump on over to the studio room and we'll talk to you guys here in just a few minutes.
All right. I think about 10 minutes left myself and I get going soon. But yeah, I can take a question.
So, yeah.
I'm ready to, whenever you all are ready.
All right.
I'm ready.
Same here.
Okay, so... Right.
Delta, come on up.
Yes.
Delta. Come on down.
Hello.
You got it. I'm in.
Yay!
Hey. Hello.
Yay.
What's up?
So easy to get in. It's so good.
Yay.
Well. Anyway.
So, what's your question?
Is the Sonic... If there's such thing as a Sonic Twitch takeover, it's probably live, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean,
uncut, that... bigger, longer, and uncut.
Yes.
Like the South Park movie.
I probably end up inviting the Sonic Song 182 crew to come on in and.
Oh yeah, they would really do a great job. We're gonna have them on as guests at some point.
Yes.
We need to have them on as guests about it.
I'll do it.
Yeah, I feel like at some point we should have like our own like Sonic R takeover, so that way we'll have like the entire show with nothing but questions from the audience.
Oh yeah.
Imagine just all the chaos.
KM's always been very, very wonderful to work with, and we always have every single year.
Yeah.
All right, Trey.
All right, I might get Trey the chance. Here we go.
Hello.
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 Hello, Trey.
Trey?
Uh-oh. No!
No! We lost Trey!
Oh, there. He's already put his hand up again.
I'm trying again.
Discord is again.
Yeah, that's Discord.
I'm tired of that.
Discord, everyone.
All right.
Discord. Again.
There we go. Hey, is it working now?
Is it working?
Oh.
Okay.
Maybe.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello. Oh, yes.
Hi.
There we go.
Hold on just a sec.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Take your time. It's all good.
Take that time as you like.
Oh man.
Da 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 da.
No, we need the Jeopardy thing. We need the Jeopardy thing.
Yes.
We need a soundboard.
We'll get there. We'll get there.
Da 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 da. Hi.
We hear you.
Hello.
Hi.
We hear you.
Hello, Trey.
Yes.
Yes, we hear you.
Yes, sir. What's your question?
I don't know. I think I have a question. But what's your favorite Sonic game?
Mine is Sonic Knuckles.
Oh gosh, favorite Sonic game? Oh wow. That's
a hard one. Sonic Adventure 2.
I know my favorite 3D Sonic game is Sonic Adventure 1. Classic game though, probably Sonic Mania or Sonic 2, because Sonic 2 is my first Sonic game of all time, and I really love how Sonic Mania did, how they revamped the classic era of Sonic games.
Oh, I would have to say for my favorite 2D Sonic game, it's going to have to be Sonic 3 and Knuckles, just because of the wide scope of all the different levels and stuff. And it feels a lot more unique than some of the other levels for some reason. I don't know.
I'm just hoping for the upcoming release of Sonic Origins.
Oh yes, for sure. I can't wait for that. The 3D one is actually sort of a three-way tie. The first one being Sonic Adventure 2, because Introduction to Shadow, my absolute heartthrob.
That's my favorite.
It's like,
I'm your heartthrob.
Oh no, that's my favorite of the bunch. So.
Favorite
Sonic character.
The second one is Shadow the Hedgehog, because again, Shadow is.
For obvious reasons.
Where is that damn fourth Chaos Emerald?
And hearing Sonic swear in there is just funny as shit. And the other one, and this is purely for storyline, Sonic and the Black Knight.
Oh, nice.
I hate the controls because I don't like Wii motion controls. I really hate it, but I really love the story of it.
I feel like at some point, if Sonic and the Black Knight were to ever be made for the Switch, that's what they're probably going to do. They're probably going to bring back motion controls. Keep in mind, the Switch is capable of motion controls, unlike the other consoles.
I can never get those motion controls to work correctly for me. They always do not what I want to do. And it was even worse than Sonic and the Secret Rings. I could not even get past the training stage. Like that.
Prologue.
Yeah, I couldn't even get past that because the controls just would not work for me.
Oh, wow.
So it's like, I just
that's a shame.
Yeah, I don't like motion controls.
Well, you always try to do this. Just keep trying and just do your best. Just try your best.
Anywho. Anyone else?
A favorite Sonic game?
Mine's Sonic Unleashed.
Really?
For me, it's Sonic Adventure.
Okay.
Yes.
I know for me, like, it's kind of a cop-out, but I simply haven't played enough Sonic games to, like, really establish a favorite yet, other than, like, the only game I've played in full is Forces, and it's definitely not Forces, so.
Fair enough.
I was like, wait, your favorite game is Sonic Forces? No. What are you from? No. But it's okay, though.
You'll play more Someday Eagle.
Sonic Forces is not my favorite whatsoever, but I do appreciate it for some of the elements that it has in it, especially the whole create your own character thing. Create your own OC at this point.
That was the only fun part I had in the game.
I mean, Sonic Forces is, for the most part, okay. I do like the element of having fans create their own, like, it's like basically having their own OC be in their game. Like, hey, remember the OC I just made? Now I can put it in my game. Like,
yep.
Oh my gosh.
If it has the Chao, it's my favorite. Yeah, no, never mind. No, favorite one. Anything with the Chao Garden in it. Yeah.
Anything with Chao Garden in it.
That's Saga 1 and 2.
Yeah.
When are they going to bring back the Chao Garden?
Yeah, that's the one cool thing we want to answer. Chao Garden, darn it.
Bring us the Chao Garden.
That's the one question we should ask for the Sonic for Takeover. Where's the Chao Garden?
Oh, we got the next card.
Chao Garden? What?
Huh?
What is such a thing?
Didn't you raise and nurture Chow at one point?
Just like,
I did. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
That's what they'll say.
I love Chow Garden. I swear, Sega is like, they need to put out a Chow Garden mobile game because yeah, they would make they would make all the money.
That should be a mobile game, the Chow Garden.
You know how, what is it, it took Daz all that time to get to 500 million? Give it a year, and I bet you 500 million will come from Chow Garden.
Not even a year. It'd probably be like half a year, because so many people want, you know, the Chow Garden to come back.
Think of all the money Sega's not making by not putting out a Chow mobile game.
Like, come on.
Yeah.
Come on, Sega.
That is like stupid easy money right there.
Yeah. Easy money.
I will throw my money into the screen just to get a Chow Garden.
Sega's not using their budget correctly. Yeah.
Yeah, no, they're not.
What did they blow their budget on?
Obviously not that. Whatever it is, not that. So therefore,
all the crossover events.
Even know, man.
Oh, I think I know what they spent the cutscenes.
Oh yeah.
So Sonic Garshare discussion just said that. Delta said that.
Alrighty, everybody, I have to get going now.
Okay.
Good night.
Good night.
Alright.
Dust, did you answer favorite Sonic game?
Yeah, Sonic Adventure 2.
Okay, yeah. Okay. So, I think that's... Did that answer your question there, Troy?
Yes.
Okay.
Alright.
Alright.
Speaking of Chows, we have Chows of the Protectors.
Chaos of the Protectors?
I think it might be Chaos of
the Protectors. Chaos of the Protectors. I'm like, what do you think is cooler, Chows or Chaos? It's Chaos!
In this time, the God of Destruction!
What's going on?
Oh, hey there.
Hello.
Hello.
Hey there.
Hello.
Yeah, before I do ask the question, is you guys are the first person to actually say that like about the name. But anyways, my question is to all of you guys, what got you guys into Sonic in general?
Oh gosh.
Oh, wow.
I actually started from the very beginning when Sonic first came out. It's like first of all, I did not own any console games like back in the day because my dad was part of the PC Master Race. So no consoles because he said computers are superior. You don't need a console. What computer can do better. But I go into like these, different stores that have the demo station set up and, you know, Sonic was on the screen. And I started playing and I'm like, and then you got the Sonic, the cartoon series Adventures of Sonic and Sat-E-M that was out, and it was just like, oh, I love this, and I was obsessed with it. And yeah,
my story is the same as Shane, except that I have Mexican parents, and so even though I've been raised as a single an only child, they didn't spoil me too much. They were pretty much strict. So they think that getting me a new console was only for boys and not for girls. So yeah, I started out with the demo and then watching the cartoon, the weekday mornings cartoon of the Adventure of Sonic the Hedgehog and the weekend cartoons, which is the Sat AM. And yeah.
I mean, my introduction to Sonic, I think it was like an after school care thing. I think it was, back then they had like a N64, and I was introduced to Mario Tennis at Cyber 64. And eventually they brought in the Sega Genesis, and I got to play Sonic 2, which was my first Sonic game, Sonic 3, not Sonic and Knuckles or Sonic 3 and Knuckles, just Sonic 3 and Sonic 3 Blast. But I was also introduced to Joe Montana Football, Aladdin for the Genesis, which is amazing. And then years later, I got to play my first 3D Sonic game, which was Sonic Heroes, and that was before I got to play Sonic Adventure DX, the Director's Cut version for the GameCube at the time. I ran Sonic Heroes at a Blockbuster, and eventually I got the game via Amazon, and I still have fond memories of Sonic Heroes. And I grew up more into the 3D Sonic era rather than 2D. And it wasn't until I got the Sonic Mega Collection where I first got to play the original Sonic the Hedgehog game, and I also played it on my iPod. Remember back in the day when during like iPod Classic, you can actually play games on your iPod. And one of the games that was on there was Sonic the Hedgehog. I got to play that. It was just amazing. But yeah, that's kind of like how I got into Sonic in general. Just some of the classic Sonic games, and then I ventured on into 3D Sonic. So that's what happened.
Okay. I guess what got me into Sonic, I think it was like back... It was either 2011 or 2012 or 2013. It was one of those years. I can't exactly recall. But my brother, he got the Sonic Classic Collection on the DS. And I guess I just borrowed that from him and, you know, failed the first couple levels. And then I also proceeded to borrow Generations from the 3DS from him as well. As well as Lost World when that eventually came out. But I don't think I really truly got into, like, the Sonic fandom up until, like, around... I'd say 2014 with the good old internet, specifically like fanfiction.net.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It kind of just steamrolled into from there, you know.
Once you get on the internet, you get locked in with that stuff.
Yeah. You get sucked in.
You're this young lad. It's like there's so much Sonic content that people have made. And it's like you just get wrapped up in the sea of it. Yeah.
Imagine doing it in the early pioneering days of the internet, but back in the late 90s. Like,
True.
Alright.
I guess I really got into it right around the first Sonic game I played was Sonic 2 on an actual Genesis, and this was about
99,
2000.
Oh, wow.
It's been a long time. And a few years later, was this Sonic X hits the scene, and it kind of draws me in a little more. It was almost like a gradual thing. It kind of just kept drawing me in. And then the internet happened. Everybody was always talking about, avoid these guys like the plague, avoid these guys like the plague. And I literally look at them like, how bad could it be? Not bad at all. It's like, not bad at all. It's like, you guys are overreacting. Like, yeah.
Like, Sonic 6? Oh, Sonic 6 or fan?
No, just the community at that time.
Oh, yeah.
Sonic in general.
It had an air about it. People were just like, don't do it. And I'm going to check it out. I'm like, there's all this creativity here. All these people are creative and all that. What's your problem?
It's a new Like, my brother who, you know, I got the Sonic games from, like, he's not even a Sonic fan, like, today because of, like, the fandom stuff. So it's, like, really funny how, like, things have turned around on our end over here.
Yeah.
And, yeah, the fandom has changed a lot when you look at it.
Mm-hmm.
And, Sigmy posted on the show discussion, I'm probably in the minority where I got introduced to Sonic first in the Sonic 1 game at my cousin's house. But became a diehard Sonic fan when I found a Sonic comic at a grocery store, issue 12, and it promoted the cartoon, and I had to actually look through the TV guide back when they still printed those to find where the heck I can watch Sonic. So basically, I didn't become a diehard fan from the game, but from the other Sonic media.
Yeah, the same thing with me, with the other Sonic media.
Yeah, pretty much me too. Mm-hmm.
Even like the cartoons. I remember like watching the cartoons when I was just like in a phase of just like wanting to watch and read anything Sonic with like I think it was like on Netflix for a little bit. It was Sonic Sad AM. Mm.
Sad AM. Mm-hmm. Good show. That's actually how I got into Sonic was Sad AM.
Yep.
Oh, right.
Mm-hmm. I think a lot of people
and getting a PS2 and got Sonic Unleashed and Sonic Heroes.
I want to say a lot of people would really get hooked with Sonic from Sad AM just because of they put their all into that particular series compared to just, you know, say Adventures of Sonic, which is just another kids cartoon with silliness in it.
Yeah. Right. Like around the same time, because like the people were like, we want to, whenever higher ups were like, we need a darker tone. So like, well, I guess we'll just make that one while the other one's airing as well.
Yeah, because I think back then, they used to air the weekday mornings cartoons because I used to watch them.
Yep.
And that's the reason why I usually go usually late for school. I'm like, it's like six. I can't remember. It was like 6:30 in the morning, and like there's the Adventure Sonic the Hedgehog. I'm like, oh, I want to watch it. And then my mom called me, it's time to go to school. Just 5 more minutes, like, we're almost done with the show. I'm like, yeah, then I get, like, to school.
It's funny. I used to watch Sonic while I was going to daycare a lot, to the point where the daycare teachers got sick of it. And they decided they're going to watch. They want to watch the Today Show because, you know, they're daycare teachers. They don't care about kids. Mm-hmm. So,
what?
Yeah.
Daycare? You watch the Today Show on daycare?
Yeah, I know.
It's like, let us adults watch the adult show, please.
Oh my God.
Like, your kids. What? It's like your kids. Go play. Like,
what shows do you watch at daycare? Barney?
I actually got away with bringing Star Trek 4 to watch at daycare.
Oh.
Oh, wow.
Because Star Trek 4 was my absolute favorite Star Trek movie, and I just wanted to bring it to daycare and watch.
Okay, and Osega Muse just posted, they made Sad AM because ABC Network didn't feel like Adventures of Sonic the Hedgehog fit the demographic or tone or whatever they wanted for their Saturday morning cartoon lineup.
Yep, that was it. That was it. That's what I was referring to. Thank you so much. Yeah.
Yeah, I think, okay, you know the irony of it all? Because I was more into the adventure of Sonic the Hedgehog than the Sad AM, because, like, my mom used to wake me up early in the morning, and I get to watch the cartoon in the morning. Saturday, however, no one wakes me up. By the time I wake up around 8:30, the show was over.
Oh. I feel like at some point, if you had an alarm clock, you could just set the alarm to that time, and then you could, then it'll give you enough time to watch Sad AM or Adventure Sonic the Hedgehog.
Come on. Those kids want to do that. Those kids want to sleep in. Like, come on.
Hey, can I?
I mean, the thing is that I didn't have an alarm clock back then. The alarm clock was either my dog or my parents.
Yeah.
Hey, guys, can I level with you for just a moment here in regards to Sad AM?
Uh-huh.
So, you know, I loved it as a kid. I really did. But as I grew older, as I became a teenager and older and stuff, I kind of realized that there are certain elements of Sad AM that I no longer like that I did like as a kid. And I think it's because I started noticing some glaring issues with the series. And that is in how they portray their feminism agenda on there, to the point where it's just stereotypical. Girls are super smart and boys are super dumb. Like the way that Sally kept tricking and teasing Sonic, and, you know, and there was even a whole episode where Sonic had a whole nightmare about Sally calling him dumb, saying, you know, where were you when the brains were handed out, and he had a whole nightmare about that. So it's like they're portraying Sonic as being, you know, like completely brainless or something like that, like, and Sally's like, oh, I'm right and you're wrong, that sort of stuff. It's just like, ugh, you know. And they would, and I know it's prevalent in a lot of Deke animation shows where the girls were super smart and the boys were super dumb. They literally call Mario and Luigi in their Mario series, like, they literally portrayed them saying they had no brains in them. Like,
I mean, what are you talking about? The Super Mario Super Show?
Yes.
Yeah. To the Mario.
So, unfortunately, the glaring problem with Deke back in the 90s was, like, the feminism was probably a little too extreme, so to speak. It's, like, you know, still not done right because it was still treating, like, boys are dumb and girls are smart. Like,
did they also have that same issue with Underground?
Yes.
When they came out?
Yeah.
Yes. It was still the same problem back then, too, because Sonya was the smart one and the boys were like, you know, whatever. To be fair, they toned it down just a little bit where Sonic was in the right, and Sonya and Manic have both done stupid stuff without their brother, so Sonic would be right in the end. Mm-hmm. There was at least a couple episodes like that, but
and actually, funny enough, Angelita. By the way, Angelita, you just said that you don't want to go on time to watch I Am. Well, Second View was actually on the same boat with you. She said, "I never wake up on time either. I set up my VCR and put in a VHS cassette tape into record that AM so I can watch it when I wake up later."
Yeah, I mean, I would have done that the same, but back then I didn't even know how to record a VCR. My parents didn't even bother with the programming VCR. They had it like 12 o'clock blinking.
I gotta mention it real quick. I don't think you can mention Sonic Media if you don't mention Sonic X. It was like everywhere, like around the
internet. Yeah, it was. I remember Sonic X. It was all over the place. It was.
Did you actually call it Sonic X a cartoon or an anime?
Anime. By technicality, yes.
I mean, I used to run SonicAnime.net, so what does that tell you?
Yeah. People were calling it an anime before, you know, it was even clear there was an anime.
Yeah.
And in this instance, a lot of people say the subs are definitely better. Because yes. 4Kids.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. 4Kids.
And 4Kids, oh, 4Kids actually went out of their way to make edits to things that should have never been edited in the first place. Like, they would blank out signs that were already in English.
Wasn't there a scene when in Sonic X where Eggman somehow flips the bird?
That was OVA. That was OVA.
That was OVA.
Oh,
right?
Yeah. True.
No, that was Sonic X.
No, this is definitely OVA where Sonic flipped the bird off.
Mm-hmm.
No. There's a scene in Sonic X where Eggman flips the bird.
I don't recall that at all.
But they did censor a lot of, like, dumb stuff, like you mentioned, like the signs. For no reason. Any Japanese food? Nope, it's American. Kids are not gonna know what those are.
Japan, what's that?
Where, like, someone held like a wine bottle, they replaced it with like a big old thing.
Sausage!
I think I remember one scene in which Knuckle enters into a bar, but it was like, it turned into like a fast food place.
Michael the Wolf put it out that it was actually a photoshopped meme.
That's what it was. Yeah,
it was just a photoshopped meme. Surprise me. That does not surprise me.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me either.
Yeah.
But it stinks too because, like, again, like they also messed with like the plot as well. Apparently, like, there was a lot more investment in the characters, I guess, with the subs than there was with the localized dub.
And funny enough, funny mention because Delta actually asked the question he asked was should Sonic characters be characterized better in later games and forms of media?
Yes.
Like in,
Shadow needs a complete fix.
Yes. No, I prefer to stand.
Oh man.
I think these dubbing companies that are changing everything to localize the food sources and all that, I think they need to realize that kids are a little bit smarter than that, and they need to be exposed to more culture rather than...
I think it stopped recently, especially with, like, you know, four kids no longer being in business.
Well, Sega, you just said the new dubbing company that does Pokemon still edit food out.
No, don't tell me that.
Because he said that they replaced rice balls with donuts.
Yeah,
what's wrong with changing foods?
It's like, can we at least have some culture exposure to these? These kids are smart.
Why can't it be like a Miyazaki film where they change absolutely nothing?
In fact, I feel that if you localize something, you're actually dumbing kids down.
Yeah, exactly. Which is why I think the biggest debate in terms of anime is which would you prefer, subbed or dubbed?
It honestly depends.
Yeah, it really depends.
That's what I was gonna say.
I honestly would rather listen to English a dub, because I don't want to sit there and read text while watching the action, to be honest.
Unless you know Japanese.
Yeah.
And of course, Segumi said Sonic X and other 4Kids licensed animation have edits where they remove text.
Yep.
Because 4Kids is what's called a worldwide localization, so made it easier to localize stuff into other countries, not just North America.
I still think it was stupid. I still think it was stupid.
Like what other anime did, when they localized it, did not change the food or anything? No Dragon Ball Z, because they never replaced a Sensu bean. What would they replace it with? A lima bean?
I think any dubs that they don't edit the food would be the ones that are more meant aimed at older kids, adults type animes.
Like the dubs that Funimation.
Yes.
Funimation is a fantastic dubbing company from Texas. They did the one anime I can think of immediately is Dragon Ball Z.
Which is why I was so disappointed when ADV got a hold of the Sonic OVA, and their dub actors were absolutely terrible. I watched Bubblegum Crisis Tokyo 2040, so I really love that one, but the fact that they completely screw up the dubbing of Sonic OVA, but they kept calling Knuckles a mole.
What?
You might know what I'm going to do.
That was a thing. That was a thing.
Knuckles was
you
not
You might know what I'm going to do, but that's not going to say anything, because I know what you're going to do. Strange, isn't it? Nah!
Oh, gosh.
That's why I was so disappointed. I was so disappointed with ADB. I was like, are y'all this stupid? Y'all called Knuckles a mole? Are y'all really this dumb? I mean, I can't tell whether it's because they really don't know what an echidna is, and they thought kids won't know what an echidna is. It'd be easier to call them a mole, or they really just don't think kids know what Sonic and Knuckles.
What do they think that they're going to call him a hedgehog? A porcupine? I mean, echidnas are technically cousins to the porcupine, so they could have got away with just calling him a porcupine if they don't know what an echidna is.
I mean, like, plus it's a cartoon, and, like, I bet you, like, even, like, most adults at the time, or even some adults still, like, don't even know what echidnas are.
I think they went with mole because Knuckles could dig holes and was digging a lot in the anime.
Mm-hmm.
Digging all those holes and popping up like a mole. Pop, pop, pop.
Pop.
Eventually getting hit by Sonic in the head. Thumbs down.
Oh. And then people talk about the Tails Mo. I don't know what that is. Oh, Tails and Cosmo.
Let people ship. It's like, let them ship.
I let them ship, but in my personal opinion, I don't think Tails should be shipped with anybody. He's 8 years old!
He's 8 years old.
He's 8 years old.
Anyways. He's a child. But how old is Cosmo?
I don't know.
I don't know. Dude, Sonic ages are, like, all over the place. Like, they were really, like, only made in, like, what, the online, thing for, like, that's, like, the only instance where they, like, gave them ages, and it's, like, not mentioned anywhere else. But regardless, they're clearly, like, a, you know, child. All right,
thank you, Chaos.
Michael says, I thought he was 11. Mm-hmm. He was 11 in the Archie comics. Tails was 11 in the Archie comics. That was the only time that he was 11. Yeah. That he's actually 8 in the official Sonic canon.
So, in the comics, he aged 3 years. Jeez, imagine what would happen if Tails was a teenager, or better yet, an adult.
We're running into a time paradox with this stuff, man.
Oh, if Tails married Cosmo, that would make him a prince of an extinct race, since Cosmo's parents are the leaders of that race.
Yeah.
Oh, that, so that way Tails could have been royal.
Yeah.
Who would be Tails' princess? If he... Oh, wait, never mind.
I was gonna say! I'm like, yeah. You know what?
I'm like, what other ships and what other characters can we ship?
Oh, don't even ask me that question, because there's only one ship for me. There's only one ship for me.
That's a can of worms. You're gonna open the floodgates, dude.
That's a can of worms. Okay. Another day.
We're not on camera now. Otherwise, I would totally be bringing up Sonic and Shadow onto the camera right now.
No, we're not.
No.
I mean. I don't know. I honestly don't. Oh yeah. Integrity says Tails is like the most shipped character besides Sonic in official media.
Yeah.
I'm like, how many times has...
Delta brings up a good point. If Cosmo reunited with Tails today, the internet would explode.
Oh, apparently, and Michael says, I would let the demons in if I did that.
Yeah, so, anyway.
Yes, I would.
You know what?
The unfortunate truth is Cosmo's never coming back. Get over it.
And with that said, I think this will probably be a great time to start wrapping up the show here, because we'll be talking about
somebody raised his hand, Night 001.
Oh,
yeah, Night
001. Okay, let's go ahead and take that in real quick then.
Yeah.
Quickly. One more.
Hi there.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello, can we hear you?
Hello? Oh, can you hear me now?
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
All right, cool. All right. Cool.
So what's your question?
Hello?
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 Can we hear you?
Hello?
Sorry, oh, hi. Yes.
Yeah, yes. We hear you.
All
right. What's your question?
This got push to talk.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I understand. Yeah.
I see.
All
right.
Yeah, so go right on ahead.
All right, never mind. So, my question is, because I started hearing you guys talking about this ship and stuff, and I was like, let me stop this before it gets ugly. let me put my earphones on.
Oh my gosh.
That's better. All right. So.
Oh no.
There we go. All
right.
Okay.
My question was, what game has the best music in your opinion?
Oh.
I knew that was coming.
Don't make me choose, dude.
No.
It's hard to pick, but there's one thing for sure is that that is not the most memorable, because I really cannot recall it, is the soundtrack of the Sonic Boom series. It's because probably, it's not the worst, but it's like you can't even recall it. It's not even worth listening to it because it doesn't even have a soundtrack to begin with. I mean, most of the soundtracks I have on my collection ranges from Sonic Adventure to down to, I don't know, the 25th anniversary of Sonic the Hedgehog original soundtrack. So it's hard to pick.
It is very
so hard to pick. Let's see, and looking at my collection, could be either the Sonic 06 soundtrack on the vocals. And probably, it's hard to pick.
I know.
Yeah.
The Hedgehog soundtrack.
There's so many,
even in my collection. There,
yeah.
A favorite child.
At this point, it's like, it doesn't matter what terrible Sonic game there is, the music has always been top notch.
Always
I always feel like the music for any Sonic game is gonna be a saving grace.
Yeah, you say that, and it's like one of my favorites is the OST from Sonic X, the Leapster game. I think it was phenomenal.
Oh,
underrated soundtrack on the Leapster.
Leapster. Oh yeah, I forgot Sonic X.
Yeah, the Sonic X Leapster game. Don't you know?
I forgot about that.
I've never heard of that.
Yeah, they had a Leapster game.
I mean, I know that they used to have a Leapster game, but I never played it nor listened to it of a soundtrack.
I was thinking you said that she's seen
all the time on eBay.
Yeah, she's seen the Leapster game all the time on eBay.
It's really tough. I would say as far as instrumental music is concerned, I think Sonic 06 had the best range of instrumental music, especially since a lot of it was orchestral. And I always get a kick out of orchestral drum and beat songs like Solaris versus Supersonic versus Solaris.
Nice.
So what do you think of the Sonic Unleashed E-Rank music? Or whenever they... Whenever
oh, God.
Don't make me sad. Don't make me sad.
I'm glad someone did that. Someone didn't edit when they did that. They switched the music that they did for that with the E-Rank, and it's so good.
Oh, wow.
Dustin said it's basically orchestral practice.
Yeah, it's like band practice.
So I think if there's
did they actually record that while they're practicing, or did they actually meant to record that?
I think it was already planned, saying, okay guys, just play as if you're practicing or that you're playing really bad. Like, you had a bad day, and you just don't feel like playing an instrument, but you have to.
And actually, I'd say...
I always gotta check out the E-Rank thing.
And actually, I'd say Sonic 06...
Better than this, like band practice back in junior high.
I guess Sonic 06 vocal tracks have the most ones I would listen back-to-back-to-back. Though,
yes.
I have to give some special credit to the Sonic R soundtrack. That was my jam back in the day before Sonic Adventure was around. So, I would listen to Sonic R day in, day out, and even like some of the other music, like from the vocals from Sonic 3D Blast, Sonic CD.
The one vocal song from Sonic 3D Blast, "You're My Hero."
Yes. And also the music from Sonic CD, the American soundtrack, because that's all I had access to at the time.
I mean, I really like the Japanese soundtrack to Sonic CD.
most people do, and not, I don't know a lot of people that actually like the American version, but I actually do, just because purely of nostalgia more than anything else.
Yeah,
like,
absolutely.
Well, I think also because the some of the music that was used for like the boss level is a little scary, basically.
Yeah.
Has anyone ever tried triggering the secret images from Sonic CD?
The secret images?
Yes, the secret images from Sonic CD. One of them.
Yeah.
Fun is Infinite.
Yeah.
That one.
I'm still trying to pick one, man, because, oh, man. You're asking the musician in here their favorite sounds. Oh.
To be fair, I don't have, I can't.
Because it's just, it does everything right. But I will say this. And let me play devil's advocate, but Force's soundtrack's up there. Force's soundtrack is up there. It is really, really good.
I like it. I don't like the game too much. It's not the best game, but the soundtrack is not bad.
Like, it's when you go in and you're just listening to the music from, like, when you're playing a level, you're just like, dude, I have to stop a minute. Why is this so awesome?
So the Sonic Force soundtrack?
like Sonic Forces.
Oh yeah, I mean, I never played that game. I mean, I do have that game, but I never even bothered playing it. But like, once I started listening to the soundtrack on Spotify, I'm like, hey, some of them are pretty good.
Yeah.
It's the main song, Fist Bump. What is it called?
Fist Bump. Yeah,
Fist Bump.
Yeah.
So I listened to that song like before I even played the game, and I was rocking out to it. And I was like, this is good. And then what game is it? Forces. I'm like, oh crap, okay.
I love Sonic Forces. Oh no.
No, here's the thing.
Even though the soundtrack's really good, I think some people bash on it though, because a lot of people say that a lot of the songs use the same instruments or are like very similar in genre. But they're all really good bops.
I gotta be honest. The vocal soundtrack for Sonic Forces actually helped me get through a rough patch in my life. I was able to relate to the songs very, very well. Ladise is probably the only one who knows what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
So
let's
just say it was a very, very dark time in my life, and Sonic Forces helped me get through it.
Oh wow.
Nice.
This is my favorite soundtrack. That is a hard one, yeah, because there's so many good Sonic soundtracks that I really like. I do like the I like the soundtrack from Sonic Adventure 1, the original. I like the Japanese soundtrack for Sonic CD. Sonic Heroes has a good soundtrack as well. Oh my gosh. Oh wow. Like, I think out of those, I think I have to go with the Sonic Adventure and or Sonic Heroes, because the soundtrack is 100% amazing. I love the music from Hank Castle and Mystic Mansion, even though I don't like the Mystic Mansion level at all, especially with Team Chaotic.
No.
No.
But the music is amazing.
Yeah, anything Adventure, like especially Adventure 2, I start crying immediately.
So like, yeah, whenever you listen to Live and Learn, whenever you play through
Live and Learn, yes. Last boss battle, I start like my chills every time. You guys prefer Adventure or Modern Era? Classic era.
Adventure era, hands down.
Oh yes.
Back when Shadow was written competently.
Oh my God! Thank you so much for saying that. I've been having the same opinion for so long. Like, what happened to Shadow? What happened? What'd they do?
Mandates happened.
Oh, Delta pointed out that the fact that Force's orchestra music is performed by the London Symphony Orchestra. The same orchestra that made the score for Star Wars and Indiana Jones.
Oh, nice.
I did not know that.
I would not have known that.
You know, it's funny because I remember that London Sympathy Orchestra did do stuff for Sonic, but and that's why that's who I thought was performing for Sonic Symphony, but somebody said no, it was Prague. So I was like, oh, well, I screwed that one up.
Oh, well. I really like the orchestra music from Sonic Unleashed. The main
just theme. About to say that.
Yeah, the main theme of Sonic Unleashed, of it being orchestral, it really is amazing.
Yes.
Yeah.
You said Sonic Unleashed?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So good.
When I popped that game in for the first time, I heard the theme. I was like, okay, this is an experience. All right.
That's why I like the trifecta of having you got to have the three main elements for a Sonic main theme music. You got to have the main theme song itself, which you know is sung. You got to have that orchestral menu type music, which is beautiful. Then you also got to have that final boss mix of orchestral and the rock song, just you know jamming out while you fight the boss, such as Sonic Supersonic versus Solaris, Supersonic versus Dark Gaia, and of course versus Nega Whistle Armor too.
Oh yes.
That's it. Those are the three main elements you got to have with Sonic music nowadays, because those are the trifecta.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Sonic Unleashed. How do you guys feel about that game?
Why couldn't this game get a remastered version?
Please?
Yeah.
Same.
I mean, I don't mind it whatsoever, but however, I felt it was a little too hard for me. I couldn't get through all of it, so I ended up just quitting like halfway through.
Do you think if you were to like replay it now, would you have an easier time?
I absolutely have no idea, to be honest.
I replayed it a couple of months ago, and it got worse. I mean, not worse, not the game itself, but like the just my problem was the metals. I was like, okay, this is slowing this or crawl, so I'm I can't do this anymore.
I think the medals were probably some of the bigger problems.
I was able to get almost most of the medals, but on the Wii version of it, not the the 360. That one, I started playing the 360 version on the Sonic Unleashed, but I couldn't even bother finish it because like every the button was a bit different than the Wii one.
Yeah, the Wii.
And
Wii
I even had to use the GameCube controller for that instead of the Wiimote.
Yeah, the Wii version was edited down because of space and whatnot, and that's why I heard the Eggman Land is a lot easier on Wii than the rest of the consoles because.
Are you fucking kidding me? I'm like, who made that stage? Because, in the daytime, I couldn't even get in, up to S rank. I'm like, who on earth will make... I mean, it's so frustrating because, the catwalk part is, very difficult because I had to time it.
I hate that part. I hate the catwalk.
I think whoever designed...
The catwalk from Sonic... For Sonic on Wii, I'm calling the Wii version Sonic on Wii. It is John. Although the thing is though, with Eggman Land for the HD version, it's just one continuous level, basically. And also, people mentioned, and Sega mentioned that. Did anyone mention Sonic and the Black Knight soundtrack? Because that one is so good.
Oh yeah.
Because I think how many songs did Crush 40 for? How many songs has Quest 40 performed in that game?
I don't know.
I have no clue.
They did Night of the Wind, Live Life, Fight the Night, Slash Into the Fire, and that's it.
Yeah.
Let me tell you, when I heard what the soundtrack for Sonic the Black Knight was all about, I was excited beyond all reason because, like, you had Richard Jacques, you know, you had Crush 40, and you had some of the other legacy Sonic performers in on this. So I'm like, ah! And the fact that it was all Celtic-inspired rock music.
Yes. And Michael said that I'm taking notes from Elliot from Super Game Brothers. I know Elliot. I happen to meet Elliot at one point. Yes, I know Elliot from SGB.
So, anyway, was there anybody else who wanted to weigh in on this before we start wrapping up? Because,
I do not know.
I think we covered the question for the most part. I think we I would say I think you threw us for a loop because music is a hard one.
Oh yeah,
it really is.
Yeah, I was listening to the show for a while. And I started thinking, what kind of question? And then I started thinking, what's my favorite song? Oh, I don't have one. Okay, perfect.
Put it on then. It's your crosshair now.
Yeah, favorite song. Oh man, that would be a hard one to ask.
Yeah, I think if you want to if you want to trip up a Sonic fan, ask them what their favorite music is, and that will be
case in point. It just happened tonight.
Yeah. Or ask if they prefer Sonic Arms blue or tan.
Oh my god.
What? You know, I get asked that, and anytime I get asked that, I just look at them and I'm like, shut up.
What question again?
It's fine. I don't want to open up another can of worms.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. I think on the last word on music, I think anything involving Crush 40 at this point is just auto win.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yes.
Oh, yeah. In the adventure. Oh, my God.
Yeah. Okay.
Next time,
yep.
We'll just talk about Shadow.
Oh, that's my favorite
subject.
The
potential South Square takeover.
You remember when Shadow was introduced? My God.
Yes. My heartthrob. My
Are
heartthrob.
You kidding me? The best intro for a character in the Sonic universe. But yeah, next time. We can just go to sleep.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
I think. I'll have more tomorrow.
I think we better wrap up before this goes into 3 hours. Like, I've been
We're pushing it.
Yeah.
Well, I appreciate it, guys. Thank you so much for having me there.
Yep.
Take care.
All right.
You guys too.
Yep. Okay, guys. Thank you for joining us. This has been fun. Hopefully, we can shorten it up a little bit better next week. Who knows? Maybe we won't go on. We need to stop going off topic every time we bring up something.
We need like a time limit.
What we need to do is get
a time limit for like each topic that we do. Like set a time limit, and once it expires, move on to the next one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So. Next week, let me check my schedule here real quick. See what I think we decided it was the 25th, which is a Saturday. I think that's when we decided that's going to be the next episode.
I can do that.
So it's like midnight now, so less than a week away.
Yeah, just, yep. So, Saturday, September 25th, that's when we'll have our next showing. And we hope to see you guys there. Hopefully, if people are listening to this on YouTube, try to check our next show. If not, we'll try to post it up online whenever we can. So, you know. But I recommend try to watch the live show. So if you want your questions answered, we'll be here to answer them for you. If not, if nothing else, maybe you can send me a Twitter at Sonic Revolt with the hashtag Sonic R Show. You can ask your question through there.
Mm-hmm.
Other than that, I think that it's a wrap for tonight. Thank you, everybody. Y'all have a wonderful evening. Remember, it's not radio, it's a revolution.
Aha.
Hey. Take care, everybody.
Bye.
Good night, everybody.
Bye-bye.